Oh, there's Alex. And Emmanuel, can you hear me? Ingrid, can you still hear me?
I can hear you, yeah.
So maybe they're just coming on.
Alex is muted.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Emmanuel, I wonder about Sage. Let me email Sage. I'll bring Sage up in Messenger.
Hello.
Hello, Emmanuel. Hello. Good to see you. Where are you, Emmanuel? Where are you now?
I am at home.
Oh, okay. Yes, yes.
Yeah, I am at home in Marafa. Here is my girl.
Oh,
hello.
Hi. Nice to see you all.
That's great to see everybody. Yeah. Hey, Alex.
So I haven't heard back from Sage other than her initial plan that she said she would join the call. So let me just check email once more time to see if she might have sent anything else. Nope. Okay. So she may or may not show up. And I know we were hoping to hear a report from her about the video that Alex and friends were making. And I show up on your screen as Cheryl Slover-Lynette, just sort of that's what that is about. Okay. So she's a colleague that's loaned us her subscription. And Alex, just want to acknowledge you're there, though we can't see or hear you. So hopefully it'll work for you to join us. And if not, I mean, visually or audio, but if not, it's great to have you on the call. And Ingrid, it's been so long.
It's been long, yes. I've been traveling.
Can you guys hear me now?
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah. I don't know why I've been having like real problems with these headphones. Sorry, guys. Oh, I'll shut up and listen now.
No, that's great. I'm glad you jumped in so we know you're there. That's wonderful.
Okay. Unfortunately, I need to leave at 9:30, and that's in about 15 or 20 minutes. So.
Okay.
But I'm glad to join you. It's been a while, as you say, Larry. Yeah.
That's wonderful.
I was also hoping to hear from Sage how the newsletter went, whether it raised any money.
Right.
Maybe you know, Emmanuel, if money came in as a result of the newsletter. Nothing?
No. I've not yet received information from Sage, though we talked, I think last week we had a talk. She has been traveling she has been traveling from Israel. Now she was home, and we did not talk much. We talked about the video that Alex is preparing, and then we talked about the situation here, and then we said maybe we can meet today for the group call.
Okay,
right. Okay. And Barbara may join us also.
Barbara said she may not be able to join,
right.
But he says hello. She wrote me a message. She says she won't be able to join, but she says hello to all of us.
Great.
Yeah.
Emmanuel, do you by chance have your earbuds handy, your earphones, microphone that you could come on to?
I don't have my headphones.
Okay. That you're fine. That's good. I just thought it might be a little clearer.
Can you hear me?
Yes. Yeah. Can't hear you. So maybe, and Emmanuel, it's just great to see you. You and I talked last night. So let's just take a short minute, and particularly Ingrid, since you have to leave quickly, we'll try to just invite in the most pertinent, potent pieces here and listen to the silence for, you know, our connection and with each other and remembering why we're here and inviting in that which is, you know, the stillness and the silence and spirit and all that ties us together. And So just remembering our roots together. So just a moment to do that and honor that. Thank you. How great to see your smile again, Emmanuel.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Can I go first?
Please do, yes. Please just jump in since we have Ingrid only for a short time. Let her hear what she can hear.
Yeah, first I want to say thank you so much, Larry, for organizing this, and thank you for all friends who are on board today. It has been a while before today, and I'm happy to say that right now at the center we have the children, but they are not going to school because it's the long period of their holiday. So now they will remain home and also at the center until 2nd of January next year. So what we do right now at the center is working to make the compound and preparing for the next year. So what we are doing right now, we have firstly are building the pig pen. It's almost half to be done, and then we are going to shift all the pigs from my place to the center. Hopefully before Christmas, we are going to do that. And in the beginning of this month and at the late last month, there was a lot of rain that caused some floods, and it was very scaring. Also, just the rain stopped abruptly, and then like today the rains stopped, and then the next day there was a very, very hot sun that even the water in the remaining water and the soil was hot. So this in some areas really caused some damage because of the hot of some crops didn't manage the hotness of the water and to observe that. But at our farm we experienced that, but there was no much damage because the crops were already up. So currently at the farm, we have vegetables like kale and sweet pepper, and also we have sweet potatoes and okra, and we had some corn. All these are now ready for harvest, so we are a little bit busy harvesting all these crops at the farm. So that is on the farm. We are doing well because we have like this year we had a continuous planting and harvesting, and we are still doing that. When it is very dry, we use the water from the well to do irrigation. So we are doing that, and in the preparation of for next year, we had the staff, that is the teachers, we had them to be trained on capacity building on the new government curriculum, so that next year we have the staff ready for to support the children on that side. What we did not manage to do, we were to build some like three classrooms, so that next year we are upgrading one level. Now we have up to standard 7. So next year we have standard 8. So the one who was to build these three classrooms said he had some personal problems that he still has to work on that, and then he will let us know. So that one could not, that project for the classrooms could not pick off within this time of the year. What we received was the money for building the pig pen, and that one we are almost done. And what we do is that we are using the bricks that we made, that the children and the community made, by having the brick machine that we purchased last time. So we have enough bricks to build the big pen. What we don't have at the center is the other materials like iron sheets and metal. This one we had to buy from outside, but the bricks we had already made by ourselves. So this really helped us, because and we were to save even more money that we could now try to get to buy bricks. We could not, we just get money to buy the other things and labor charge, and that is happening right now. Also, in the beginning of this year, we had we applied for grant from the European Commission, High Commission, and they said that it was during the financial year of 2018-2019. So we received a note that our grant application will be extended to next year. So still they will come back to us and let us know if we were successful or not. But they said they received it, and it was located for the 2019 half of the financial year. So we had also applied for another grant. This grant we applied was for the peace, building peace within the community, and also training a community on how we achieve peace from the soil, and how we protect the environment to be at peace with the environment, with sustainable farming. All this bring peace with the people, because when they come together, they can talk and share about what they really affect them. So we had applied for grant for this from the Global Center for Global Center. So they have been contacting us, and I think it was yesterday they called me and they said we need to submit our audited report for our financials, and we already have the audited report, so we sent that. So hopefully, maybe if they will turn positive, we may get a grant on that note. I want also to speak about the irrigation project. We had the money from Alex Bukin, and this money was to go to the water project. And still the irrigation project is still under the water. So it was not enough to install the irrigation system. So we still had to add, this money is still there and we still need to add. So Jaquelina Barra from Italy said that she so far raised about 3,000. So she's planning to come from next year. And when she come with, I told her that from next year we had planned to start the project by preparing the land and marking all the lines as per the measurement of the irrigation. So when she comes. We can have the irrigation, drip irrigation installed. So far that is what we have, and we have this time until that time. We also had the children for the Christmas. Christmas celebrations, we still have to raise funds for that, for the Christmas celebration. And there were, so what we need right now is maybe for the Christmas celebrations and the children were to go to trip this holiday. We have not made that one, but it is still proposed. So if anyone can pick on that, it's also okay. So what we are preparing here right now is to make sure that the children, when they resume class, then we have all the needs for the continuing to be there. And also something I wanted to report on is about the library book. We had applied for book in Nairobi and we were lucky, we were selected to get a library book. And these books are now in Nairobi. We need to pick them up. So for the library, they gave us some books. I don't know how many yet, but they called and they said they have dispatched the book and we need to collect them. So maybe on 2nd or 3rd next month, I will go to Nairobi for the Deep Democracy Institute seminar. So I wanted when I go to the seminar after that, I can collect the books. It can be one trip instead of me now going to Nairobi, pick the books, come back, and then going back for the seminar. I said it will be good. I go for the seminar, and then I pick the book for the library. So we were lucky we were given books for the library. And we had the shelves that we made. So we have a place to keep the books.
That's wonderful.
Wonderful. Great. What great news. Yeah, thank you, Emmanuel, for sharing all of that. It's very uplifting. I feel very happy to hear good news. Thank you. So now I have to say goodbye. I'm sorry to leave you all. Lots of love to everybody.
Thank you, Ingrid.
Thanks, Laurie.
Yeah.
Bye, Alice. Yep. Bye, Emmanuel.
Bye-bye.
Thank you. Okay. Bye. Okay, Emmanuel, is there more you'd like to keep reporting?
I think I have shared the what I wanted to share. Okay. And what we need right now, we also going to, because of the heavy rains that we had, the most of the toilet pits, the holes of the pit were eroded from the bottom and filled with water. So we need to empty these and see if we can we can repair those. And I requested Ayako to I thought she would be in the call, but she's not there. But because maybe we are recording, she may be able to know. I yes. requested Ayako this some money to, if possible, to repair these eroded toilets. So she said she will get back to me. She has not got back to me, but she said she will get back to me. So when she said she will do it, then that one will be covered. And hopefully she will be responding to that. Not sure if next week or when, but she knows that we need to do that before we resume the learning at the center. So that was also something I wanted to share, that it is a need, and we need to repair this pothole. But I requested for some support from Ayako from Japan. So if she said okay, then we are going to get that support, and we are going to repair this pothole. And she wrote to me. She said that thank you for the email, and I think about that and get back to you. So I'm still waiting for her to say something. So that is what I wanted.
Yeah. Yeah, great. I hope that works for her to do that. That would be wonderful. I've got some questions. Maybe Alex, you do?
No, just happy to hear it all. Yeah, sometimes I get into the groove and sometimes I get out of it. So good to catch up.
Uh-huh. No, that's great. I'm really glad to work for you to join us today. So Emmanuel, given sort of the dollar funds, so with Jackie's funds, she thinks she has maybe $3,000 now or can bring that.
She said that she's now traveling to Argentina and she will try to raise more. So. Okay. When she comes back from Argentina to Italy, she will let me know how much she will have. And she said she will also communicate to you on the same.
Great.
She will be communicating maybe how much she will have raised from there, and we see what we can do.
Wonderful. Yeah, I'd still love to get up a crowdfunding page, and but you were looking for, was it like 6,000, 5,000 to 6,000 for that to complete the irrigation on top of what Alex had donated?
Yes.
Okay. That's helpful. And for the Christmas fund this year, we were talking, can you just refresh my memory there?
For the Christmas, we are looking for, it's, I think normally we spend 1,200 or 1,300. So if we target like 1,500, that one can work all, everything.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. And the holiday trip, I know I can look at it in an email, but that was similar, right? About $1,500 or so?
About 1,200 around there. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. And that's great about the library books. That's really wonderful.
Yes.
And
we have the friend, the news, the reporter, they said they also suggested us to be supported with library books by the Kenya National Museum. So we still also waiting for the Kenya National Museum to respond to that. So we are waiting. We are not, if they say yes, that means we are going to get some more books.
That's great. Of course, I know you'll post photos or whatever, but let me know when you do get books so I can let my friend know that donated money for the shelving to, you know.
Yes, yes. I will let you know from next month when I go to Nairobi to pick the books.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll make her happy to know that that's great.
Yeah.
And that's great. You get to do the deep democracy piece in December in Nairobi.
Yeah, it will be on 7, 8, and 9. It is this weekend. It will be a 3-day workshop. And after that, I will teach the book and come back.
Yeah, okay. Let's see. You mentioned a grant had been applied for. Was it from the European Commission or some commission? There was a grant. I didn't catch who that was from.
We applied was for the building is from the Australian High Commission, like the Australian Embassy here in Kenya.
Oh, that's right. The Australian Embassy. That's right.
And this was the community peace building. It is it is global center, something like that. But it is they have an NGO called Kenya Community Support Organization, which we are going to get the funds through them. So we are communicating from that.
Okay, great. Wonderful. Well, lots going on as usual.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Well.
Well, guys, it's good to hear you both and talk. I'm a little bit sort of my finances are a little bit tricky this year, but hopefully next year it will all come together and I'll be able to help more. So I just want to say that, and let me turn on my video for a second so you guys can see me.
There you are. Well, Alex, you've done a lot. And you do a lot, you know, and yeah, so we appreciate that acknowledgement. And your finances are better next year as well.
So, yeah. Hey, dude. Hey, Manu. Hey, oh my God, like everybody's here, huh? That's incredible.
It's great to see all of you.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right. Thank you. Alex, I'm at home, and my family was waving to you.
I could see that. Hey, family, I'm waving too. So, guys, I'm gonna drop off. Okay. Really appreciate hearing everybody. Thanks a lot. Keep me in the loop. Alex.
Yep. Thank you so much for joining.
All right. Take care.
All right.
Thank you.
Have a great day. All right, Emmanuel. It's down to us.
Yes.
It's just nice to take a moment and feel your presence and of your family there.
This connection is very clear. It's not like the Facebook connection.
This feels better to me as well. I'm glad to hear that it does to you. It's automatically recording, and so it'll be interesting to see how the quality of that comes through.
Yeah.
I wonder, maybe since we have this sort of good connection and pretty good video, how about just sort of give me a short spiel about the irrigation project? And if it comes through with enough quality, maybe then I could use that on a fundraising, page. So, you know, the... So let me prime it this way, Emmanuel. So late last year, a well was put in at the center where the Margarita Children's Center, where there's some 200 plus, maybe 250 children, and a organic permaculture kind of farm. And maybe roughly half the children are orphans. And the center is providing education as well as an education, I mean, formal education, as well as an education in how to live with the land in what you call peace to the soil. Maybe just speak to this and what any money that people can donate and help in terms of as climate change occurs there, it's more and more important that you be self-sustaining in food. And that's what this irrigation project can help do, correct? Maybe you could speak.
Yes.
Okay.
First, I want to say thank you so much, dear friend and dear friends, for this effort and love and support. Yes, after the installation of the well, we were lucky to have water, though it is coming from 200 meters beneath, but it is sweet water that provides a really life to the children and to the community within the surrounding. And I want to say my heartfelt gratitude to all those who are
Looks like we froze up for a moment, Emmanuel. Bummer. So is it me? Emmanuel, I don't know if you can hear me. I'm going to try maybe restarting the call. Let me send you a new link to try. So check your email. Okay,